Each our meetings will begin to speak about happiness. I have to say that I'm really happy to be here this wonderful snowy day in Astana. So, Mr. Toastmasters, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Vivat, and I'm the one who's going to break the ice today. So, I am 31, I am married, have a small daughter. Her name is Emma. She's a very sweet and charming girl with white curls like I have, you can notice, right? So, there are three important things that influence on my life. First one is my grandparents. The other one is my experience before I begin my healthy way in healthy company. And the third one is my current job. So, I would like to begin with my grandparents. So, my grandfather, whose name was Nail, passed through the Second World War and he raced through the Shuskin up to the rector of one of the most respectable universities in Kazan. So, when we were children, me, my twin brother and my sister, we spent our holidays, summer holidays at our village. So our grandfather had a schedule for each of us where there were a lot of responsibilities and duties for everyone. So he had a lot of friends. 17 years passed since he died, but still most of his friends call to my grandmother and visit our village at the day of his birth. So one important lesson I learned from my grandfather. He instilled me love to hard work and also the importance of friendship. So my grandmother is an English teacher. So she instilled love to literature and art. She helped us to visit musician schools when we were children. So the second part is my life before I start my huge career. So I was graduated at Kazan State University of Architecture and Building Construction. So my student life was not full of events because we had a lot of drawings and a lot of calculations. But as you know, I was lucky to be a part of work and travel program. I visited Alaska with my twin brother and we met a lot of different nationalities over there. Philippines, Americans, Mexicans, Ukraine guys, and even first Kazakh students I met over there. So this opportunity gave me chance to visit New York, Washington DC, Seattle, San Francisco, lots of cities in America. So I have to say that this trip opened my mind and enriched it with new knowledges. So that is the second story, right? So you can laugh, but when I graduated my university, I wanted to go to army. So you know, my parents are doctors, and I could easily buy ticket, army ticket, but I didn't do it, probably because of my grandfather. So how to say, you know, educated people used to say that army doesn't give anything. So you can just lose your time over there, so it won't help you in your further life. But as for me, I learned one very interesting lesson about army. So you see, when you are in army, you face a lot of difficulties. Cold, hunger, dedovshchina, sorry, and other things. So because of lack of vitamins, your body begins to rot. For example, I lost like 5 times nails in the army, and I still have some marks on my legs that remind me about the army. But you know, when you pass through this darkness, you can learn one simple lesson that I did. So after this darkness, you are nothing afraid of in the civil life. So it's very easy to be to struggle the difficulties after this darkness. That was the lesson. So right now I am the leader of Hilti Engineers in Kazakhstan. Hilti company, okay? So I have two simple aims. First one is achieving the outstanding financial result by doing negotiations with developers, designers, and construction companies. And the other one is developing young engineers to share my knowledge and experience with them. So I want them to be a good professionals like I am. So I want to thank my mentor, Adia, for helping me to prepare this speech today. Thank you, Adia. also I want, as I began, I want, I'm here to break the ice. So, Mr. Toastmaster, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your attention. I hope you enjoyed my live speaking.